Analysis and design. We have completed 5 units. So today we'll be starting with the sixth unit, which is feasibility study. In this PPT, we will be covering topics like feasibility study, types of feasibility study, and what are the steps involved in feasibility analysis. So as we have already studied feasibility study in life cycle of system life cycle. So it's a second stage which comes after recognition of need. So feasibility study is an activity that verifies whereas an information system can be started or can it get successfully completed or not, whether that system will be beneficial for the organization or not. The main objective of feasibility study is to test the technical, operational, economical feasibility of the system. So feasibility in Hindi will be sambhavta, if I'll say. यहाँ पे हम चेक करते हैं कि क्या जो सिस्टम नया सिस्टम हम बनाने वाले हैं या शुरू करने वाले हैं वो सिस्टम हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के लिए बेनिफिशियल होगा या नहीं होगा, या जो सिस्टम हमने बनाया है वो आगे चल के हमें प्रॉफिट अर्न करके देगा या नहीं देगा. सो देर आर द पॉइंट्स विच टेल्स दैट वट इज़ द नीड ऑफ फिजिबिलिटी स्टडी. सो इट डिटरमाइन द पोटेंशियल ऑफ द एग्जिस्टिंग सिस्टम. फिजिबिलिटी हमें ये बताता है कि जो एग्जिस्टिंग सिस्टम है वो क्या बेनिफिट्स देगा, या फिर नया सिस्टम आने पे हमें क्या बेनिफिट्स मिलेंगे. इट फाइंड्स टू डिटरमाइन ऑल द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द एग्जिस्टिंग सिस्टम. फिजिबिलिटी स्टडी में हम सारी प्रॉब्लम्स जो हैं सिस्टम को लेके उनको एनालाइज करते हैं. वी डिटरमाइन द गोल ऑफ द सिस्टम. वी फाइंड ऑल द पॉसिबल सॉल्यूशन टू कम अप फॉर द सॉल्यूशन. दिस टेक्नोलॉजी यू नो इट रिक्वायर्स टू सॉल्व ऑल द प्रॉब्लम. And it determines what hardware and software is required to obtain the solution. That all comes in technical feasibility. कि क्या hardware और क्या software लगेगा वो हमारा technical feasibility में आ जाता है. It determines the cost requirement. कितनी cost हमें लगेगी इस system को बनाने के लिए, और क्या जितना हम cost invest करेंगे वो cost हमारी profit से कम होगी या ज़्यादा होगी. That all comes in economical feasibility. So next we'll discuss the types of feasibility. So we have 3 types of feasibility: technical, operational and economical. We'll study these types one by one. Technical feasibility refers to the technical resources needed to develop or install or operate the system. Okay, so it does what? It measures the following issues. Issues like, does the company have the necessary hardware or software? Then, does the company have the requirement for that technical expertise or not? Will the system will be able to handle the transaction volume or not? Will the hardware or the software environment will be reliable or not? Technical feasibility we have studied earlier also. ओके, जहाँ पे मैंने आपको ये बताया था कि अगर मैं किसी रिमोट एरिया पे फाइल प्लान टू इंस्टॉल अ सिस्टम विच रिक्वायर्स इंटरनेट और विच रिक्वायर्स एजुकेटेड पीपल टू ऑपरेट इट, देन इट विल बी यूजलेस. व्हाई? बिकॉज इन दैट एरिया ना ही इंटरनेट की फैसिलिटी है और ना ही वहाँ के लोग इतने एजुकेटेड हैं कि वो उसे ऑपरेट कर सके. तो ऐसी जगह पर वो नया सिस्टम इंस्टॉल करना विल बी यूजलेस. तो टेक्निकल फिजिबिलिटी यही चेक करती है कि क्या जो हम सिस्टम बनाने वाले हैं उसमें जो टेक्नोलॉजीज यूज़ होने वाली हैं क्या वो बेनिफिशियल हैं या नहीं है. देन कम्स योर ऑपरेशनल फिजिबिलिटी. इट्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड बिहेवियरल फिजिबिलिटी. इट फाइंड आउट वेदर द purpose of the system will be suitable or not. Okay, it measures the proposed system that will be used effectively after it has been developed or installed. Okay, operational feasibility measure the need of the various users who are affected directly or indirectly by the system. The impact on the organization structure, the salary, the jobs should be considered here in operation. And system banane ke baad us system ko operate karne ke liye jo hame training chahiye वो भी इस फिजिबिलिटी स्टडी में देखी जाती है. इट फाइंड आउट इफ एनी जॉब रिकंस्ट्रक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड और नॉट. इट वॉचेज द फीलिंग ऑफ द कस्टमर्स एज वेल एज द यूजर. सिस्टम शुड प्रोवाइड अ राइट एंड एक्यूरेट इन्फॉर्मेशन टू द यूजर और द कस्टमर एट राइट प्लेस एज वेल एज द राइट टाइम. सो इकोनॉमिकल फिजिबिलिटी, सो एज द नेम सजेस्ट, द इकोनॉमिकल फिजिबिलिटी इज ऑल अबाउट द कॉस्ट एंड द बेनिफिट. That profit or loss, what profit says that the selling price should be greater than the cost price. So it's same here also in your economical feasibility. Okay, the cost conversion existing system to proposed system, the cost should be remolded. Okay, and the cost of the hardware like operating system application, these all cost should be less than your profit cost. यानी कि आपको profit ज़्यादा होना चाहिए. That all is measured in feasibility, in this economic feasibility. So here development cost is measured, operational cost is measured, you know, the cost of operation of the existing system is measured, what man power is required, what material is required, equipment, okay, overhead expenses, the salary, okay, the training required to the paper, support staff, everything is calculated here. So next comes the steps in feasibility analysis. So in feasibility analysis, it involves 8 steps. Number 1 is form a project team and appoint project leader. That means the first step involves forming a project team. Okay, so here the project team will be like analyst, the user staff. Okay, when who is analyst, we have studied it earlier that who is the analyst, user staff. Okay, so we have to form a team where the people who are trained, who can work on that system are hired. The projects are planned to occupy special time ranging from week to months. Okay, the project can vary from week to the month. And second step is prepare system flowchart. Here we are going to prepare the generalized system flowchart. What flowchart tells? The flow of the system, how the data will be flowing in the system, how the system will work. The information oriented chart and data flow diagram prepared in this investigation phase. Okay, and the chart bring up the importance of the, like, what will be the input, what will be the output, how the data will flow, what are the key points in the existing system. That all we have to tell in this phase. Third step is enumerate potential candidate users. This step identifies that the candidate system that are capable of producing the output included in the generalized flow chart. Okay, this requires a transformation from your logical to your physical system model. Okay, and another aspect will be considered is the hardware that can be handled to the system requirement. Okay, that we are going to check in this phase. The fourth one is describe and identify characteristics of the candidate system. So in this step, the analysis is mainly based on what the candidate system can do and what it cannot do. You have to characterize it before only, that what your system is going to do or what your system is limited to, bound to, what it cannot do. For determining this, the technical knowledge and expertise in the hardware and software area are very critical and are must required. Fifth step is determine and identify characteristics of candidate systems. Here the analyst has to determine and evaluate the performance and cost of the system, that the how the system will be performing. Evaluation for both design and implementation is performed here. Okay, it includes users training, updating the physical facilities and documenting. Okay, and your sixth step is weight a system performance and cost. data. That means according to the performance and cost of the system, something is given to each alternative. Okay, like multiple, so many number of, for us one problem, number of solutions are given. And in those number of solutions, we are going to hire the one which is we feel is best. Okay, so here procedure for weighting the system is assigning a weight factor for each system. Okay, we can assign the quantitative rating to the system. We can assign the category of the system. ठीक है, score कर सकते हैं हम हमारे system को कि कैसा system का score होगा. ठीक है, so the seventh step here is select the best candidate system. In जो आपका previous phase था, that weight system performance and cost data, that means हमें different different point रखने हैं, different different पर्सपेक्टिव अपनी तरफ से बताने हैं कि सिस्टम कैसे कैसे अच्छा हो सकता है, या अलग अलग एक प्रॉब्लम के मल्टीपल सॉल्यूशन प्रोवाइड करना है. उसी तरह आपका जो सेवेंथ स्टेप है जो कहता है कि सेलेक्ट द सिस्टम द बेस्ट कैंडिडेट सिस्टम, तो इसमें हम क्या करेंगे, फ्रॉम द नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस वी आर गोइंग टू पिक द बेस्ट वन, द वन विद द हाईएस्ट स्कोर वी आर गोइंग टू पिक दैट. It assumes the weighting factor, ठीक है, are fair. तो क्या assume करता है कि जिन factors के साथ आपने आपके system को points दिए हैं, या फिर जहाँ आपने उनका system performance का weight निकाला है, that is all correct. You have assumed that evaluation जो आपने करी है, जो evaluation criteria आपने follow किया है, that is correct. And the last step here is prepare and report final project direction to the management. Here after feasibility analysis, a document called feasibility report is prepared and it is directed to the management. आपके management level को वो report जाती है. This report is formal document for management use. It should be brief, sufficient, non-technical to understandable. Why it should be non-technical? Because your management is not the technical persons. They are not the one who have expertise in technical language. Okay, so you cannot use technical or jargon words there. आप जो report बनाते हो वो हमेशा ऐसी बनाई जाती है कि आपका user अगर पढ़े तो it should be understandable to user also, and if the management studies that report then it should be understandable to that also. So these all 8 steps were used in your feasibility analysis. With this we have completed half of the part of 6th unit. In the next PPT we will be finishing with your 6th unit. Thank you.